Hey guys, this is me again, making a couple of videos today. I went to the thrift store today, got a couple of packages in the mail, and also some other stuff that has arrived earlier this week. And I made a trade with somebody for some navy patches. This will be the first video of probably two, and it's a package that has arrived today at my thrift store finds. So let's see what I got. This is an Dutch army uniform, the woolen trousers. It's the battle dress like the English army had in the Second World War. The Dutch used it until the 60s, also with the suspenders. And this is the jacket. I bought this jacket and trousers for, I believe, 25 euros plus shipping, so it's nice and complete. It is from the technical service. This was done from the 50s till the 60s till the 70s. This uniform was worn in the late 40s. So directly after Second World War. This is from a guy. I bought it from the family. The guy passed away. He was a veteran. As you can see here at the ribbon bar. It's for the first political intervention in the Dutch East Indies. It's now called Indonesia. Was a former part of the Netherlands, an old colony. After the Second World War, they wanted to have their own country, and the Dutch intervened. It was a lot of fighting from 1946 till 1949. This guy has two stars. Each star is one battle tour of 1 year. So the guy was there for 2 years. As you can see from here and here, it was a member of the technical service, Technische Troepen. I bought it because of this. It's a patch I have never seen. As the ribbon bar also clearly states, it was worn in country. This has to be some form of patch only used over there. I think it's for fortifications, because you see a Roman tower and like silhouette for a vesting, for like a fortress. And this is the Dutch lion from the army, Regiment 3. It's French for I will maintain, something like that, roughly translated. It says ik zal handhaven in Dutch, so I will maintain the law or order, how you will want to pronounce it. This is the label, and it's also stamped MVO. It says Ministerie van Oorlog, so it's a war department. It's a size 48. I don't know if you can see it very clearly. Often it's faded. It's almost no lining in the jacket, so that also states it's an early piece, because a lot of shortage of stuff. And also the suspenders is stamped MVO. Then I've got this from eBay. It's a blue drillighose, and it's like for work detail pants. It's made out of blue linen. As you can see, it has a certain pattern. Don't know if you can see it, but it has the like a V shape in the fabric, and you can recognize it is Second World War and probably Luftwaffe issue. There's a nice stitching for repairing. Obviously it's not marked, but this you can see a loophole. You can put it on a hanger or stuff on a nail, or like some for in the barracks. It's very short loops, but often it was tied with a string. This is a zinc button, so all war trousers have the zinc button on top. The other ones are, I think, from iron or something like that. It's not stamped, it's not marked, but it's quite usual. I hope you can see it in all its glory. I bought it for, with shipping, 30 euros, so it was quite cheap. Very glad I have bought it. Most of the time the pants are tough to find, because they were still worn after the war. I know of a guy I know, his grandfather was a painter after the war, and he, in the Second World War, he was a medic, and he still used the trousers and the field blouse. Obviously the eagle was torn off, but he still used it for his painting job, so that's why the trousers are worth, I don't know how much money it's worth. It's like 60-70 euros probably. I would think more, but yeah, the market is not that that great for that kind of stuff. But it's an original piece, and they are quite hard to find. So this is some stuff I attended an auction. I usually sent a bidding form, so a paper bid. Bought these two lots, one for Luftwaffe and one for like the Hitlerjugend, Bund Deutsche Mädel stuff. This is a ribbon bar for a good service in the Luftwaffe and the Air Force. 4 years, little bit of rust damage, but nice eagle. Same for the medal. You can see the Air Force eagle, and it says "Für treue Dienst in der Wehrmacht," and then on the back you see the number 4. It's a little bit hard to see maybe, but there you go, that's a 4. Altogether I paid 150 euros for each item here. You might think it's a lot of money, and I will say it is a lot of money, but I had to pay 18% commission, I had to pay 20 euros of shipping fee, and again 3 euros for a different kind of fee. I don't know what it was for, but okay. So I paid 100 euros for it, but there's about 50 euros of commission to it, so not all that happy about it. But when I see how they packed it, it was packed quite well. It was signed shipping, so I had to sign for it, so I think it's worth the money. It's worth the 20 euro shipping. They definitely want that the item will arrive on the right place. And I bought it from Wormser Auktionen. It's in the city of Worms in Germany, and I live in Holland, so but as I speak fluently German, and it's the third time I've attended the auction with the paper bid, and this is the first time I actually won something. So definitely will be trying to get some more auctions, do some more bidding. I only bid it on 3 lots, these two and another one. The third one was for a mine clearance badge from the Kriegsmarine, from the German Navy, Second World War. I bid around, I bid 90 euros for it, because I already have one, and I had paid 90 euro for that. But it went away for 120 or 140, I don't know exactly the number, but it went for a little bit more, and that was not something I wanted to pay for it. They're quite there are quite still a number of those things out there. So this is for Hitlerjugend and Bund Deutsche Mädel, so that's the women's Hitler Youth. This, it's quite hard to get a focus, but it has RJA, so RJA, and it stands for Reichsjugendabzeichen. It's a sports badge, and it has a red around it, and beneath it is a small swastika. It's very hard to get a focus of it, but small pin, and it says Bernstein JB. So obviously it was produced by some kind of firm. This is something I'm quite proud to own. It's some kind of brooch worn on the neckerchief from the women's department of the NSDAP, from the Bund Deutsche Mädel, the BDM. As you can see, a big swastika, and the corn, or how do you call it, the aren from the wheat to make bread. And it says here in Sitelunschrift, so that's the old German writing, that it was awarded, so you could not buy it, you had to be awarded with this, that the woman, this woman who wore this, she helped with, yeah, the Obst, I don't know the exact English word, she helped getting the crops from the land, so she helped with that, and then probably for the potato harvest, corn, wheat, stuff like that. It has a very nice patina, so it's obviously worn. On the back it's a little bit green tarnish, and but it is also numbered. Don't know if you can see it here with my finger. It says 5041. So this was awarded together with a certificate with this number. So obviously it's not given out to many people, I think, because it's a 5041. So obviously an early piece, I would think so. I like the Sutilinschrift, the old German writing. I like this with the wheat stuff. I like the swastika. I like that it has been worn. It has a nice tarnish. It was well worth the €60 bit for this and the €40 bit for this. Just too bad it's a little bit flaky on the bottom, but okay. This is the thing I really wanted. I am a collector for over 20 years, and it's the first time I've ever seen one in person. I knew they existed, but never seen one in person, and when I saw this I was all over it. So I'm very happy with this badge. Just one of a kind thing, I think. Then I went to the thrift store today, and I bought two little books, Bambi and another Bambi. It's given out in the Netherlands by the Disney Book Club, so it's a Disney bookstore, Disney Book Club. And this one was printed in 2001. It has very nice graphics. Paid 75 cents for it. I like it. Maybe gonna sell it, maybe gonna keep it for the kids in the future. I don't have kids, but who knows. And this one, also Disney Book Club. And this one is printed a little bit older. First print 1979, but this is a print from 1994. Also, when you buy this kind of stuff, look if the graphics are still okay, if there is no writing on it, and It's still a very nice piece, a little bit worn on the covers, but other than that, for 75 cents each, it's a popular theme, Bambi, so probably gonna make some money on it. I bought this book. I was a former customs official, also a former police officer, and also a former immigration officer, so I have a lot of law enforcement background. Still working some similar job like that, but I work now for the Dutch railway company, as also as a security officer, but it's not from the government, it's semi-government. But that's why I collect a lot of also police stuff, custom stuff. I just still have a big interest in the old stuff. This is a book about the war in the Amsterdam underworld. So it's like a mobster book from Amsterdam. It has a lot of people who were in the Dutch news. A lot of people got killed in the 80s, early 90s. There was a big war in the Amsterdam underworld, so this is a book about it. Pay €2.55 for it. Probably first gonna give it to my brother. He also has a big interest in this kind of matter, but he has a lot more free time than I have. So I still also do a little bit of learning for my job for the Dutch Railway, so I don't have that much time to read now. Only free time I have is for my girlfriend and for the picking hobby. So this is something I'm definitely gonna read when I've finished my courses, but so far for that. I've bought two sets of wooden shoes, the Dutch word klompen. I bought it for decorative stuff. I'm gonna give it to my mother. She likes to hang them. Just drill a hole in it and put it on the wall. You can put some flowers in it. They were actually used. They're the older style with hand paint. And these in red, little bit bigger size. I used to walk on them until I was 13 years old, back at the farm where I grew up. It was not an actually farm, but it was outside of the village, so I just walked around those when I was at home, and when I went to school I wore the normal shoes, but they're quite comfortable to wear. It's also good protection if something falls on your feet, you don't have injuries and stuff. So just gonna give that to my mom, just a small thank you. Always remember when you're picking and you can get some small stuff you can do somebody else a favor with, just pick it up, and it's worth it's a small gesture, but it's all worthwhile. My mom also collects stuff with hearts. She's a big garden enthusiast, so bought this for 75 cents, just to put plants in it or stuff and just hang it. You put a screw in between here, you can hang it on the wall and you can put some flowers in. So it's quite nice, and I hope she enjoys it. Okay guys, this is the end of video 1. I will be making a second video, but this is it for part 1. Bye bye.